The election is more than a year off, but the leading Democratic candidates for governor are already staking out differences on how to reform health care and are cautiously approaching an issue that has long been untouchable in California politics, Proposition 13. State Treasurer Ayer John Chiang, former state schools chief Delaine Eastin, Lieutenant Governor Gavin Newsom and former Los Angeles Mayor Antonio Villaraigosa sought to introduce themselves Tuesday to voters who are barely tuned into the race to succeed Governor Jerry Brown. For 75 minutes, the four fielded questions on health care, education, housing, immigration and climate change at a Chronicle-sponsored forum at the City Club in San Francisco. The sharpest differences were on healthcare. Newsom and Eastin favor a single-payer plan similar to one that cleared the state Senate this year before being shelved in the Assembly. Chiang and Villaraigosa said they support the concept of universal health care, but were skeptical the state could afford a single-payer, Medicare-for-all-style system. Also, Newsom, Villaraigosa disagree about universal health care. Calif. GOP rallies around measure to repeal new gas tax. Of all the arguments against single-payer, the most specious is cost, said Newsom, referring to a 2016 UCLA study that said 71% of health care expenditures in California were already paid for with public funds. The study found that for many Californians, a public-run system is already the reality. But Newsom would not say specifically that he backed SB 562, the single-payer plan that stalled in the legislature. Eastin said she supported it. In May, an analysis by the State Senate Appropriations Committee estimated that SB 562 would come with a $400 billion a year price tag. Half of that could be funded by enacting a new 15% payroll tax, the analysis said, and half could be covered by existing federal, state and local spending on healthcare. A second analysis, commissioned by the bill's sponsor, the California Nurses Association, found that single payer would cost $330 billion a year. Villaraigosa said he supported a universal coverage plan 2 decades ago while serving in the legislature, but couldn't get any support because the funding plan was shaky.